I'm Kirsty Meekin from Naio Nails. In this video, we're gonna do Power Ranger nails. Go, go, Power Rangers! Dee, 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 dee. Go, go, Power Rangers! Mighty Morphin Power Rangers!
It's just like 1990s Power Rangers.
Yeah, because I don't know what the theme tune is now. So these are inspired by the shapes and the masks and the emblems and the costumes. So that's where we're taking our inspiration from. So I've seen on some really old outfits, and I'm saying really old, they probably are 1990s or 2000 Power Rangers. Power Rangers have changed so much over the years, and the brand new film that's coming out is like super, super modern. Like Transformers kind of modern, like a whole new generation of Power Rangers. So these holographic stickers, we've used these in previous videos as stencils. You can use them as stencils, or you can actually use the sticker. So I'm going to use this here. So I'm going to bend. I'm going to place it there, press that down, be nice and thin. So we're going to fold it, and as you fold it, it'll start to, can you tell they start popping up? I'm going to use that one. There we are. Press that down. Let's get another one. Oh, I'm getting covered in them already. Any excess, you're just going to file that off. The blue that we've got in the background is this gorgeous colour. Then we need one of these. I'm going to pop one here. Don't press it down until you're completely happy where it is. Do you realise when my daughters watch this, they're going to put me correct on everything that I say wrong about Power Rangers, because they are like diehard Power Ranger fans.
Just say, well, it wasn't like that back in my day.
Yeah. When I was little, it wasn't like that.
Power Rangers went on when you were little.
And then we're going to use these gorgeous holographic strips. I love these so much. I could just stare at them forever. There are thin ones and thicker ones. Towards the ends, they're pretty much the same size. And then they go thin, thick, thin, thick, thin, thick, thin, thick, thin, thick. I'm going to use a thin one. And I'm just going to take off what I need. Oh, you did. These tweezers are so rubbish. I'm going to cut the end of this strip at an angle so it fits the cuticle a little bit better. Press that little bit down. I'm just going to use the back of the brush to rub that down and snip off the excess. So this is an easy design. It's also wearable. It's not too over the top or in your face like, oh my God, I am the biggest Power Ranger fan going. It's just inspired by it. I'm going to file off the excess of those little stripes. You can use striping tape as well. I just really like these little holographic pieces. I'm going to seal those in now with Urban Graffiti top coat. This has no sticky layer. I will do two coats of this. Make sure you go right to the edge, make sure you cap in your design, else it will peel away and you don't want that. So I think that's a very wearable design. Anybody could wear that. It's Power Rangers, but in a wearable way. It's the blue Power Ranger, obviously. So we're gonna use the black Urban Graffiti gel polish, which is 0002. I always think that the helmets look a bit like the Fly.
They've got big bug eyes.
They've got like big eyes, haven't they? Like big. Like if you had a bike helmet that just had big eyes, kind of thing. Chicken wing. Just look how black that is. I love it. You can do nail art with it. Love it. You don't have to layer it and layer it and layer it to get the colour. I'm going to do the outline of the bottom part first, just so I know exactly where I'm going. And they have this funny mouth section. It looks like a mouth, but there's, you know, you can't actually see their mouth, which I always find a bit weird. I think it's to make it look more human.
Yeah. I don't know if it moves.
Doesn't move. Not what I've seen anyway.
Because sure. You're watching every Saturday morning.
Do you know what I mean? I'm always watching it. I'm going to take off a sticky layer. If I try to paint on top of gel that still has a sticky layer, it will not be very successful. So I'm just going to go around the outside with a bit of the yellow. And then we're going to use white. So I just made a bit of a wash with the white, added water to water it down. Right, what I'm going to do now is seal this with the Urban Graffiti top coat. Now I'm gonna get the mirror chrome. We love the mirror chrome. And I'm gonna rub it into the mouth bit. And I'm gonna rub some here. And then I'm going to take a little smidge of the Urban Graffiti top coat. I said that quick, didn't I? Urban Graffiti top coat. Urban Graffiti top coat. Can you say that quick? Urban Graffiti top coat.
Urban Graffiti top coat.
and it has like a spiky kind of, I think it looks like a unicorn horn, but it's not.
Everything looks like unicorn horns to you.
Now we're going to do the mouth. Now even I can't really see what the hell I'm doing, so God help you guys. Pop that in the lamp. Now I'm going to wipe over to reveal what we have just put on. Gel residue, wipe off solution. And so this doesn't chip away, I'm going to seal that again. I'm going to put some cuticle oil on. Let's give that a rub around. So that's a mask inspired design. Mask helmet, I don't know what you want to call it. Those weird things that they wear on their head that makes them look a little more crazy than they do already with that jumpsuit on. They look like they're ready to jump out of a plane, don't they? They look like they've got
like
them.
The worst skydiver.
Sky, I mean, if someone told you to put one of them on and jump out of a plane, would you? Yeah. Would you wear that? It's like a fashion disaster, isn't it? Power Rangers outfits are a fashion disaster, I think. However, the new ones in the new film look pretty sexy. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to do some more designs using those skills and techniques, and I'll show you what it looks like in a minute. So there you are, that's the full design, completely finished. So if you have a little look here, you can see that I've took inspiration from different outfits on this one. This one is a very simplified version of the Red Ranger's mask. He has this sort of visor kind of thing going on. So if you think the other ones are too difficult, you could give that one a go. And then this one here, oh, is the Yellow Ranger, and his helmet is like, is it like a saber-toothed tiger or something like that? That's what it's like, yeah, it's like an animal. Because we all have different animals, don't we?
Zords.
Oh my different god, different zords.
Show my nerdiness.
So yeah, this one's inspired by that. So it is obviously the mask, but it's got that, it's got the fangs and all that. There you are guys, I hope you've enjoyed that Power Ranger inspired little nail tutorial. Give us a thumbs up, don't forget to subscribe, and all the products we use today are in the description box below. Check us out on Facebook and Instagram and my Snapchat, Kirsty Nails, and I will see you in the next video. Bye bye!
That was the whole good point about
Power Rangers. Because it was just so ridiculous.
It was just ridiculous,
the
yeah.
Costumes were ridiculous, weren't they? Especially like the villains.
The Rita Repulsa.
With all like the big. How did they actually do anything with them outfits on? That's just crazy. I bet they were dead heavy as well. Because they must be filled with foam and they like going, and all that. Something like that. Go, go, Power Rangers. Mighty Morphin Power Rangers.